Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you're watching. The channel's called Ratchet. My name's Andrew, and in this episode, we're going to be starting work on the 40. Run the title. Welcome back to the channel, or if you are new, thank you for tuning in. Be sure to hit the like and subscribe button below so you don't miss any future videos that I do release. You can go back and check out episode number one where I introduced the GT40. On today's instalment, we're going to be starting to strip the interior. So let's seat number one. I love the look of these seats, but they are so uncomfy, and I'll tell you why. Because you sit so slouched down in the chair, and because there's no padding to the underside of your thighs, if you drive the car for more than an hour and a half or so, you just get such a numb backside. So if I keep these seats, what I think I'll do is have built up far more support here, so your backside doesn't slide forwards in the seat. So hopefully it will stop some of the pain that you get in your lower back and on the top of your backside. But yeah, very cool seats, leather and Alcantara. So they're decent, so they're worth trying to save, I think. So seats out, harness is out, started to strip it down, but you can already start to see it's so basic and bare. One thing I didn't do was actually give you a sort of a once over around the interior of all the things that I have done on this one. The biggest thing was changing up the dash. So you can see here now, it's a flock dash. When I got the car, it was hydro dipped in carbon fiber. And it just looked it wasn't to my taste, let's put it that way. And also what I've done is I made the aluminium switch panels that you can see, and actually reconfigured the switch layout as well. On top of that, I fitted a new, I think it's an NRG quick release steering boss. The previous one was just like a hex clip on one, and there was quite a bit of play in it,
which I really didn't like. So fabricated a little boss to fit on the end of the steering column, which I then welded on and then had 3D printed a boss that fitted on the steering wheel end and then just married it all together.
One thing I am quite happy with how it turned out was fitting these one-piece door rubbers. Now, I know it doesn't sound like much, but on some of the GT40 kits, they just have a rubber that starts here and then just runs around and finishes there. There's nothing along the bottom that some people fit. Some people do. And then generally speaking, there's never really a rubber that returns around the door jamb. The previous carpet was just cut a little bit too short. But again, like I say, all of this carpet's being ripped out and replaced. Then if we move around so you can see the firewall, you can see the rear window, you can see the air filter and the big Holley 600 carb that's on there. But again, it's as nice as the interior was, it was clean and tidy, but all of these joins in the carpet, I want to try and do away with and just try and get a bit of a higher quality finish. Now, I'm certainly no upholsterer, but I've done some over the years. So I'm fairly confident that with some pattern making and just taking my time, I should be able to hopefully get quite a good result.
That was a very brief tour of the interior. So now what I'm going to do is pull out the dash.
Result. Right, now the column's out, all that's left to do is disconnect the harness.
So after being upside down a lot, I think I'm just about ready to pull the dash out. But there might be something I've forgot, but let's have a look. Happy days. Right, so the dash is out.
And there's the interior. So let's get the carpets out. Absolute
comedy genius. What a donkey.
Some bits are better than I thought they might be, other bits
certainly aren't.
It's going to be a fun project, that's for sure. So that's the carpets out, let's hear about stripping the rest out now. Okay, so as you can see, the interior is pretty much stripped out now. I removed the centre tunnel just to see what was going on underneath there. Basically, when I was driving the car, I was getting a huge amount of heat soak from the through the aluminium, and it was heating up the interior, something crazy. These are the feed and return pipes to the radiator in the front, back to the engine. So it's nice to see that they've been exhaust wrapped, but I think what I will also try and do is either put some heat reflective tape on the inside of the tunnel covers, certainly on the portion of the fiberglass one at the front, to try and keep some of that heat from transferring through. So that's basically the demolition complete for this episode. If you like what you've seen, make sure you hit the like and subscribe button below so you don't miss any future videos. Following this is a cheeky video montage, love those, just so you can see exactly how the interior is at the moment. And the next episode, there's a whole load more carnage, so make sure you tune in for that. Well, that's gone and done it. There's no going back now.